Hey everyone, this is Philip from PCPartPicker, and we're going to be putting together a gaming PC targeted at about the $1,400 price point. Big thanks go out to Amazon for helping with this build. They put together a special landing page linked in the description below that includes all the parts that you see in this video. For our part list, we're using an Intel Core i5-4690K CPU, a Corsair H100i cooler, the MSI Z97 G45 gaming motherboard, 16GB of Kingston Beast RAM, a 240GB SSD from PNY, a 3TB hard drive from Western Digital. It'll all be housed inside a Phanteks Enthoo Pro case and powered by an EVGA 650GS power supply. So let's get started. This is our Enthoo Pro case. As you can see, it's an ATX case and it's set up for really good cable management. On the bottom is a shroud. We'll remove that and install our power supply. Next, we'll install the motherboard, but first we'll insert the CPU since it's easier when it's outside the case. Unlatch the CPU bracket, flip it back, and gently lower the CPU into place. Then latch the cover back into place, removing the black protective cover. Now we'll install the backplate for the H100i cooler, but first make sure to slide the nuts into the LGA 1150 position. Flip the motherboard over, and then screw in the standoffs. Before we put the motherboard in the case, make sure to install the I/O panel cover. Be careful because this can be pretty sharp. Then gently lower the motherboard into place. And then we'll screw it in. Next, we'll connect the power connectors for the motherboard to the power supply. So we have a 24-pin connector that attaches to the side of the motherboard, and then also an 8-pin CPU power connector that attaches to the top of the motherboard. We'll run these along the backside. And then while we're here, we're going to go ahead and plug in two SATA cables and a PCIe power cable. This is for the video card and for the hard drives. Now route the 8-pin connector through the top slot. There's not a lot of play in the wire, so it may be a little bit difficult to route it around, but there is enough room to make it through. Connect the 24-pin connector to the motherboard. Now we'll install our USB, HD audio, the reset switch, the power LED, the hard drive LED, and the power switch. Now connect the USB 3 header. Be really careful because this connector at a right angle is pretty difficult to get plugged in. It's very easy to bend the pins on the connector, so don't force it. Now we're going to install the radiator for the H100i. So first we remove the top panel. We're going to lower the fans down in. The fans will exhaust air out the top of the case, so it'll pull air through the radiator and out the top. Then gently lower the radiator in place. Make sure that the pump doesn't drag across the motherboard. And then holding the radiator and the fan together, we'll slide a screw through the fan until it threads into the radiator. And then we'll gently screw this into place. We won't tighten it down all the way. We're just putting it in there so that we can get everything kind of lined up so we don't have to hold it. We'll put one more screw in the other side on the other fan. Again, just to hold things in place. Now we're going to go ahead and screw in the other screws for the radiator and the fans. Now we'll install the CPU block. There's a bracket that goes over the top of the cooler. That bracket lines up over the top of the standoffs and slides over the top. So our load is down. You'll notice that the CPU cooler actually had the thermal paste pre-applied, so we don't need to apply any additional paste. Then we'll use the thumb screws and screw those down on top of the block, and then follow up and tighten them down with a screwdriver. We'll plug in the connector from the CPU block to the CPU fan header on the motherboard. Then there's also a plug that connects to the cooler itself that has headers for two of the fans that are attached to the radiator. We'll run that through the backside. Now this is a USB header. This allows us to control the cooler with the Corsair software. Now we'll connect up the fans that were attached to the radiator to the fan plugs that we just connected to the CPU block. And then there's also a power connector, which is in the form of the SATA connector. So we're going to go ahead and plug that into one of the SATA cables that we attached earlier. While we're here, we're also going to attach the SATA cable to the fan distribution point that's behind the motherboard tray. Run the fan connector from the fan controller on the back through the slot and connect it up to the auxiliary CPU fan connector. Then the USB plug that we routed from the Corsair cooler will route down through behind the back of the motherboard and to one of the available USB connectors. We'll install the RAM into the motherboard, making sure to put it in the appropriate two slots based on what the motherboard manual says. Now we'll connect up the hard drives. So we have two drives, so we're going to connect up two SATA cables in SATA 1 and SATA 2. This is our SSD mount on the back of the motherboard tray. We'll remove it and then screw in the SSD. Then we'll go ahead and plug in the SATA cable and then also the power connector. And then we'll attach it back to the case. So this is our 3 terabyte Western Digital drive. We're going to remove the drive caddy. Stick it into the caddy. And then lower that back into the case. Then we'll connect up the SATA cable. And also the power. For our video card, we're going to lower it into place to figure out which slots we need to remove. So we have two slots, offset one from the very end. Remove those covers, and then gently lower the video card into place. Once it's latched in, go ahead and screw the cover plate screws back in. Now we'll connect up the power connectors for the video card. This video card uses an 8-pin and a 6-pin connector. So the PCI Express cable that we used has two 6+2-pin connectors. So one of them will use the 6+2, and then on the other one, we'll fold back the 2-pin connector to use just the 6-pin. Now we're going to do some cable management and tidy up the cables. This is kind of an iterative process. Sometimes you have to remove some of the cables and disconnect things and kind of rerun things. But this is just a quick overview of the process that I went through to do the cable management for this case. I didn't spend a whole lot of time on it, but you can get an idea for just how easy it is to do the cable management here with the Velcro straps and also with the wire ties and so forth. All right, so this is our cable management job. Could be better. It's not too bad, but for a short amount of time, I think it'll pass. Thanks again goes out to Amazon for sponsoring this build. We hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching.